All right, so in this last lesson, I want to talk about saving and exporting your documents. You've created your designs, everything looks great, and you're ready to go ahead and output it. But first, you're going to want to save your document. And you don't want to wait until the end of your design, your end of your work, to actually save the file. This saving is something you're going to want to do at stages throughout your design. Because trust me, if you spend hours on a layout, you're not going to want to go back and have to restart it all over again. If something happens, if your system crashes or Photoshop crashes, these things can happen. You're going to want to save your documents as you're working. But let's say, for instance, I've got my design ready. I'm going to go ahead and save. So you just simply go into the File menu and go to Save As. And you can choose your destination where you want to save it. In this case, I'm just going to go ahead and save it to my desktop. And down here is where you choose the format you want to save it in. Well, if I know that I'm working in a layered Photoshop file and I want to keep it that way because I'm going to want to go back in there and modify the layers as I work, then I'm going to want to go ahead and keep it as a Photoshop format. As you can see right here, it's the first item. And it's indicated in the name as a .psd. So if I wanted to maintain my layers, I'll simply select that item and click Save, and it will go ahead and save that document out. Now, another format that will support layers is the TIFF format. If you choose that, and it will save a layered file, the problem is it will make your file size a little bit larger. So I wouldn't use this to save a layered file unless you have a client or someone asking you specifically for a layered TIFF file. But just know that TIFF does in fact support layers. Now the other common formats, you'll notice there's a lot of different formats in here, but unless you're working with very specialized service bureaus or anything like that, the most common formats you're going to be using are going to be the Photoshop PSD format, Photoshop EPS, the JPEG format for web and other things like that, and PDF, as well as the TIFF feature here. So those are the most common formats you're probably going to see when you're receiving Photoshop documents from other people. And you can choose any one of these. I'm going to go ahead and choose JPEG. Now, when you want to output a file as a JPEG, what's going to happen is it's going to flatten your file, and you don't necessarily want to do that. So one of the things I like to do is I go ahead and go under the image menu and go down here to duplicate. And in that duplicate file, I'm going to go ahead and flatten it. And now I can go ahead and save it as a JPEG and just go ahead and choose that and save it out. And I'm still keeping my layered version as well. So we'll just click that and choose JPEG and it will save it out and everything's all good and well. Now, another way of saving your documents is going in doing the Save for Web. If you go into the File menu, you can go down here to Save for Web and Devices. And what it's going to do is open this giant dialog. And this is only critical if you're a web designer and you are developing graphics for a website and file size is critical and perhaps if the color management is critical. So you'll notice you can go in here and choose various formats. I can choose a GIF, JPEG, or PNG. And you can modify various settings here. You can set the quality of your JPEG. You can go in here and choose how it's going to load, progressive. Choose your monitor, whether it's going to be on a Macintosh or a Windows platform, and various settings like that. And when you click Save, it'll go ahead and save it in that specific format. So it's having the same way as saving as a JPEG in a sense, but you have a few more features available to you to optimize the file a little bit more. So that's saving for web, and that's saving the file in a general sense. Now, let's say you're ready to print your file. What do you do? Well, when you're ready to print, you simply go into the File menu and go down here and choose the Print command. And you'll get this giant window here, and you'll get a preview of your image. And you'll notice right away, one of the first things I look at is that the file might not be the right size for the right size media that you're going to be printing on. And if it isn't, you simply click this button right here and it's Scale to Fit Media. So it'll take your layout, no matter what size it is, and scale it proportionally to fit whatever media you're going to be printing on. So that's a very cool feature there. Up here is where you would choose whatever printer you're going to be printing on. If you're connected to a network printer, you would go ahead and choose that in here. You can go in here into the page setup and modify various other things like the paper size and other page attributes like that. You can change your orientation. But you can also change the orientation right here. Notice it'll turn the paper so it makes the print go the other direction. Very cool there. And you've got other bounding box. You can go ahead and turn that off. You can see it's giving me a bounding box area. You've got the color management area here. So if you are going to a very specific printer and you want to use perhaps specific profiles, you can go ahead and do that right in here using color management features. And the rendering intent depending on what type of setup. Again, these features are going to depend on what printer you're using. So you're going to want to get those specs from your printer or from a service bureau that you're using before you go off and start using these features. But that, in a sense, how you would go about printing your images. And when you're ready, you simply click print, and you're good to go. So that is basically how you save your files. And again, as I mentioned earlier, you don't want to wait till the end of designing your document that at that point to save your file. You want to make sure you're saving as you work. Once you do something critical, and what I like to do is if I do something really big, if I've applied a filter or I've done a really intricate effect on something, at that point I always save. I can't stress that enough. You want to save it because if you spend a lot of time creating a certain effect and something happens, you're not going to want to have to go back and do that again. A lot of times I've done really, really involved effects and the system will crash or something will happen, and I just didn't want to take the time to have to go and redo that. So saving the document is a very, very critical thing. Now, if you've done an effect, now here's an interesting point about when you go about saving documents. If I've done an effect and I like it, and I go ahead and save, and I go off and I experiment a little bit and I achieve a different effect I didn't intend on, then I save another version of that file. So let's say, for instance, I go into the file and I do a save as, and we'll call this music. Let's call it music 1. And I'll save it to the desktop. And let's just assume I've gone and done some other effects. Let's say I've gone in here and I'll maybe colorize it. Use my hue saturation and I'll do a little bit of colorization here. But I like this and I want to save it for later use. But if I save, if I go under file and choose save right here, it's going to overwrite that document I just saved a moment ago. And I don't necessarily want to do that. So I want to go to save as, and I'm going to call this music 2. Again, it's going to save it as a layered document because it's a PSD format, but now I have both versions of that file. You can see on my desktop here, I have Music 1 and Music 2. So as you're working, be aware of that. Whenever you do something where you do a critical effect or something, that's what you're going to want to do is save it as a different name, and that will give you both versions of the file. So just a small point there on saving. All right, so as we wrap up this course, I just want to stress something that I've been mentioning throughout the course is, go in there and experiment. I've given you the kind of the basics of all these various tools inside Photoshop of going in and trying different things to correct your images, retouch them, generate selections, but just go in there and experiment. In my years of using Photoshop, the best way to master these is to just go in there and practice. I can only show you so much, and I hope this has given you a good primer for going in there and getting started, but it's up to you to go in there and really master these tools and make something out of them. So, another important aspect of this, have fun. It is a lot of fun going in here and doing all these kind of really cool effects inside Photoshop. So just enjoy it and see what kind of cool things you can do.